illness is wide-ranging. It can take many forms, and it does not discriminate. Like Kevin Love, even the healthiest and most physically fit people in the world can suffer from it. And its role in athletics today is the subject of the conversation between John Keating and Dr. Deepak Prabhakar, Henry Ford's director of sports psychiatry.
We equate athletes with being, you know, fit and strong and superhuman. How much does mental illness affect even those kinds of individuals?
Yes. So I think right from at the offset, mental illness by itself isn't prevented just because you are physically fit. Now, individuals who may be physically fit, they may use that as a leverage, that's a point of strength that can help with certain treatment programs that we want to put in place eventually. But the short answer is physical fitness doesn't prevent mental illness from occurring.
Have you found that athletes are willing to open up a bit more these days about those kinds of things?
Yes. So I think we are moving in the right direction. We have taken first few steps, recent disclosures by some well-known athletes related to their own struggles that has opened a door. When you look at this, and when people who are in power, who are high achievers, when they are able to comment on their own early struggles, that opens the door for others to kind of, have some conversations, have the dialogue going. So that's definitely a positive step, but I must say, this is still the beginning phase. We want more of that.
Because all of these athletes, from the time that they were kids, have been told, suck it up. That's true when dealing with these kinds of things as well, correct?
Not with mental illness. So if we have clinical depression, if we have clinical anxiety, if we have somebody who is actually going through challenges, then we want them to be in appropriate treatment. That whole attitude about just work hard or suck it up doesn't work. Now, if we treat these conditions appropriately, effectively, in a timely fashion, then you see better outcomes, not just in sports with performance, but overall lifelong outcomes.
How much are you seeing it in younger athletes these days?
Yes, so as the awareness is growing, more and more parents, more and more teachers are asking these questions and wondering, what if something else is contributing to a player not performing or a player struggling more than they would have expected, given the discrepancy between the skill set and the actual performance?
What red flags do you see that parents should be aware of if their kids are in sports but they're struggling with mental health issues?
So sports, it should be a matter of joy for kids. This is something that they should look forward to every single day. This is something that gets them out of bed and say, okay, I'm going to go there because I'm going to have a great deal of fun and I really enjoy it and I'm good at this. So warning signs are things that keep them away from this. If these are the kids who are staying away from school, missing practices, not doing those things that they tend to enjoy generally, those are some of the red flags. Many times kids reach out through social media, send out what we'd like to call cry for help. Now, I think it's up to us on the society in general, are we capturing those incidents or those moments where a teen is asking for help? As you may have heard, some of these social media platforms, they are also making an effort to go above and beyond and share those messages with concerned parents or social authorities as appropriate.
And all those kids are helped by the star athletes in the NBA in particular, admitting that it's okay to have those feelings.
Yes, it definitely does help when they see somebody who is an high-achieving athlete who comes from a point of power, has gone through similar kinds of struggles. That gives them hope. That gives them somebody who is modeling a behavior that we really want them to model, which is everyone goes through struggles. You will be fine if you have access to appropriate and timely care.
And again, we'll continue the conversation throughout tonight's broadcast and again after the game on Pistons Live. But for questions or more information, please visit foxsportsdetroit.com, where we provided several links to assist you. Right.